Hey, Physique Freaks, how's it going? Scott Tuzina, MetabolicMasterpiece.com. It's Thursday, November 26th. Happy Thanksgiving to all my American friends. I got one of my American friends, Sarah, coming to visit me. She drove 8 hours from Wisconsin to come train with me for the next few days. We're going to have a blast. Going to be getting some footage from all of that. We're going to be hitting a bit of legs today, mainly working on her technique. She's going to join Rick and I for chest and triceps tonight. Then I'll get you the rest of the footage for the rest of the weekend. Going to share the meals we eat. We're going to have a blast. Let's get to her.
Woke up at 6:30 a.m., grabbed myself a cup of coffee with a drop of 2% milk. A little later on, brought Chief out for a walk. Then around 9:30, time for breakfast. 8 egg whites, an extra large egg, spinach, peppers, cooked in half a tablespoon of coconut oil, topped with a bit of ketchup. 10 o'clock, train a client. Then 11 o'clock, Sarah joined me at the gym. And today we're just kind of working on form and technique. And one of her focuses was squat. She just wanted to check out her form, make sure it was good. She has lifted with 135 pounds, so 45 pound plates on each side. Just wasn't sure if her depth was good. So here we got 20 pounds on each side. I was just testing her out with this weight. We had previously done, I saw her form and I thought, can she go deeper? So we did a goblet squat and I saw that she does have some great depth. So I'm like, oh, let's go with a lighter load and see how it feels. See if we can work on that depth. If you've got it, you might as well use it. And this is looking awesome. So we only have 10 pounds on each side here, which is still really good. And she's got some excellent depth there and good form. One of the things we changed was her stance. She was a little bit wider, so we made it a little bit more narrow and had her ditch her shoes and just go in socks. And that seemed to make a bit of a difference as well. Really happy with her squat form here. And so we'll just build up her strength from this point. She's got some great strength with her legs, so we just have to work on building it up in that bottom range of the motion. Post-workout, we had plain Greek yogurt with some frozen berries, and we added a little bit of protein powder to it. Sarah went to do some shopping. I watched the Lions beat the Philadelphia Eagles, and I enjoyed a bit of frozen yogurt, caramel pecan frozen yogurt. I think I'm looking at about 250 calories here, so just a nice little treat. And then around 3 o'clock, had some almonds. I ended up having two little tiny small handfuls here. And Sarah came back, joined us for dinner. We had some rainbow trout, and as well some salmon, some homemade fries using yellow potatoes, and some mixed veggies. So it was fun having her meet my family, hang out, and just get some insights into her family life. And around 8 o'clock, he went and joined Rick at the gym for a chest and tricep workout. So here we're talking about a little fear, trying to get her set up how we like to lower the weights down. So the way she kicked it up there is how I would do it if I was doing a shoulder press or an incline dumbbell chest press. It kind of, the way she did it there, limits you on how much weight you're going to be able to lift. Here she's got 30-pound dumbbells and making it look effortless. We're trying to go for about 6 reps here, and she did 8, like, no problem at all. Rick and I handed her 40-pound dumbbells, and she crushed it. So just working over that fear factor of having those dumbbells on your knees and just rocking yourself back comfortably, keeping those dumbbells in tight to your body. And here we are on the incline barbell bench press. She's never done a barbell bench press before, and she was rocking this exercise. It's important to note, we already did 8 sets of 8 for the grande dip, so chest dips there, and then the dumbbell bench press, and then coming to this incline bench press. She's got 7.5 pounds on each side here, and making it look easy. She could have definitely had 10 pounds on each side, pumping out 8 reps here. She's got some really good strength. I love her focus and form and technique, and her willingness to learn. And she's just a very, very coachable student, really putting the tips into practice right away. And here we are doing some 21s for cable flies. So 7 lower, 7 upper, 7 full. Decent lighting here, seeing the veins popping out, some decent striations. It's always interesting the different times of day, how some of the natural light comes in front of us. It can differently cause a little different visual impact on what we're seeing here with the camera. But I am really happy with how I was feeling here. how things are looking. Really excited to get down in the aerobics room tomorrow and record a video progress update for this Shredded saga along with Rick. So we're getting near the end of completing 6 weeks in this cutting phase, and I'm really happy, really excited, and gonna keep on pushing it for a few more weeks. Here we got Sarah doing it. I'm realizing the camera is a little blurry here. I didn't realize that last night. My old 40-year-old eyes are not as good as they used to be, but she's got a nice little chest vein cutting across her right pec there leading up to the shoulder. I really wanted to try to get that in there. And Sarah is nearing the end of her building phase right now. She's been really focused on adding some muscle after her last competition. So she took some of the advice from the judges and where she needs to focus on building and shaping her body. And it's just really exciting having known her through the internet, through being an online coaching client of mine for the past few years, and her following the Metabolic Masterpiece workouts, the Aesthetic Muscle Plan, and just kicking butt with all of those, and seeing her eagerness, how she's gone from transforming her physique, dropping some really good amount of weight there, and getting ripped up for a photo shoot, and then taking it to the next step and competing, and now looking at just continuously improving her physique. We've had some great conversations about how when you're cutting for an event like a photo shoot or a transfer or a bodybuilding contest, there's that intense motivation. Nothing's more motivating than knowing that you're going to be stepping on stage. You're going to put in your best effort. You want to look your best up there. But what happens afterwards, and trying to keep up that same level of intensity, motivation, drive to improve your physique from there, it's a mindset game, and just finding those different things can motivate you, inspire you. Me having a workout partner like Rick, we're always challenging each other and pushing each other. His anterior delts, front delts are just popping out like they're looking phenomenal. So we're lucky that we can really feed off of each other's successes and always encouraging each other to grow. But when you're training on your own, what are some of the ways that you can stay motivated even though you don't have a contest to or a photo shoot to aim for? Post-workout, 10 o'clock, grab a little bit of leftover salmon.